and grab that right there. Are you ready?
Hey.
Is you ready?
Ready.
You say you ready.
Oh.
Whole squad ready.
Ready.
Is you ready?
Huh?
Are you ready?
Ready.
Is you ready? Whole squad ready. We came here to see Jet. What you got? No, no, no. Not on my watch.
No way.
This is Green Bay. This is Tidal Town.
It is small town America. It's blue collar America.
There's nobody that matches up with this place right here.
The Packers represent something very unique in the NFL, in the fact that it's essentially publicly owned.
The atmosphere, the fans. The Packers are the NFL at its roots.
We love our history. We love our tradition.
You just feel like you're going into the heart of football.
There's a connection there between the team, the players, the coaches, and the community that's priceless.
The Packers, there's just not another team like them. It's the greatest story in sports.
You can be a little guy with a great ambition, great determination, and great skill, and you can succeed in America. In many ways, that's what Green Bay represents.
In my opinion, there wouldn't be any professional football without the Packers and their tradition in Green Bay.
This is Lambeau Field. This is where the Lombardi teams practiced and played.
Lombardi changed everything in terms of race with the Packers.
It was uncommon to draft African Americans in the first round, but Vince Lombardi broke the mold.
He didn't see black or white, he just saw green and gold.
I've always said there's no better football city than Green Bay.
The fans showed up for us. That was my family.
Green Bay Packer football, it is part of the fabric of life, not only in Green Bay, but the entire state of Wisconsin, and in many cases beyond.
Have you been to Lambeau Field? That's the number one place to go.
Everywhere you go, you bump into the history of the National Football League.
The NFL began in small, medium-sized markets, and the Packers are still the root of that. Their stadium's in a neighborhood.
It's unlike any other experience in the league. Oh, God, it gives me goosebumps right now.
The Packers have become a symbol of success in the NFL.
It's a history book. It's a history book of the National Football League.
Hey, everybody. We are joined by Packers president and CEO Mark Murphy. And Mark, let me get this straight. The NFL's smallest market is awarded the league's biggest off-season event. I think congratulations are in order.
Well, I think for everybody, we are so excited and honored to be able to host a draft in 2025. This is something we've been working on for a while. I think we started the process in 2016, and I'm just really happy, not only for the organization, but for the whole community. Actually, the entire state's going to benefit from it. As you said, it's a huge event, and it grows every year, and it's going to be spectacular. I'm really, really excited for the community.
How rigorous was the process?
It's very rigorous. I mean, it's basically right behind bidding on a Super Bowl. And really, you know, you think about what the league has done. They have gradually built this into a major event. The impact it's going to have on us, and because of that, you've got a lot of cities that want to host it because they know the economic impact. And what's going to make it special in Green Bay is the passion of our fans. The way they support our team, not only Lambeau Field, but when we travel. I know our fans are really going to be excited about having a draft here in Green Bay. This is basically a two-year commercial on, you know, all the benefits of and all that Green Bay has to offer.
What's this going to mean for Green Bay, Northeast Wisconsin, and really the entire state?
Well, from an economic standpoint, it's going to probably be around economic impact of $94 million. You know, to put that in perspective, Larry, we know our games are huge for this community, and that's $15 million. So it's more than six times the impact of one of our single games. you're going to have people staying all over the state, you know, all the way from Milwaukee up to Green Bay. The other thing, I think a total of about 54 million people will be watching the draft on TV and, you know, seeing shots of Lambeau Field. And, you know, the benefits of this will not only be immediate, but will be lasting as well.
What were the selling points that convinced the NFL that Green Bay was a place to be in 2025?
Well, our history and tradition, obviously the organization. You know, Lambeau Field's probably as iconic as it gets. But I think more recently, Titletown. I think that's a big attraction, and obviously not a lot of people across the league have seen Titletown. So I think that's a real positive. And then, you know, having the Resch Center so close to the what we call the Lambeau Field campus, I think makes it very positive. I think we'll have to work through the details of exactly where the stage is, but I think all three of those facilities will be front and center and get an awful lot of attention.
Mark, certainly a team effort. Who are some of your partners, not only in getting to this point, but moving forward?
Yeah, well, internally, I mean, we've had a lot of people working on it. Gabrielle Dow has really headed up the effort internally. Aaron Popke's been crucial to that as well. And then, you know, it's the community efforts. It's not just the Packers. Discover Green Bay and Brad Toll have been instrumental. You know, one of the sad things of this, Larry, and I know you knew Mark McMillan well, he was actively involved and really took a lead on, you know, doing the things we needed to get the draft here. And just sad that he's not going to be able to see it, but he's one of the main reasons that we're going to have this. And, you know, our board, and particularly the executive committee, and, you know, under the leadership of Tom Olson and now Susan Finko, have been very, very supportive of this. They see the long-term benefits that the community will gain from this. I'm just so proud of our organization and the way that a local community has rallied together. I think it's really going to be exciting. It'll be the largest event that's ever been held in Green Bay. You know, I think we're ready for it. We know that the work starts now. We've got a couple years to get ready for it.
Thank you, Mark, and once again, congratulations.
All right.
The 2025 NFL Draft, coming to a Green Bay near you.
Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my old life behind. Not a yes sir, not a follower. Fit the box, fit the mold, have a seat in the foyer. Take a number. I was lightning before the thunder.
Thunder, 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 thunder,
thunder, thunder, thunder, thunder, thunder,
thunder,
thunder, feel the thunder. Lightning and the thunder. Thunder, feel the thunder. Lightning and the thunder. Thunder, thunder. Kids were laughing in my classes while I was scheming for the masses. Who do you think you are? Dreaming about being a big star. They say you're basic, they say you're easy. You're always riding in the backseat. Now I'm smiling from the stage while you were clapping in the nosebleeds.
Today that the 2025 NFL Draft will take place in Green Bay, in and around Lambeau Field and Titletown, and couldn't be more excited to partner with everybody across Green Bay and certainly the Green Bay Packers. And here today representing the Packers, Ed Policy, Chief Operating Officer and General Counsel. So I'll have Ed come to the podium. We're thrilled to be headed to Green Bay for the draft in 25.
Thanks, Andrew.
Well, thank you very much. And on behalf of the Packers, I'd really just like to thank the commissioner and Peter and the entire league staff and really the entire ownership, I would say, for developing the draft into the spectacular event that it's become. We're very proud and honored that you've entrusted us to host the draft in 2025. Now, as Peter mentioned, as I think as we all know, the draft has really become and evolved into something much larger than just a celebration of football. It's really now become a broader celebration of human potential. We all get to witness live as the dreams of young men and their families come true, and we get to watch the fortunes of our favorite teams rise and fall based on the methodical decisions and gambles and trades of GMs who know far more about this game and its players than we ever will. So it's no surprise that the draft has become the NFL's biggest off-season event, and you know, perhaps maybe even one of the biggest events of the spring. And Green Bay is the perfect place to host this sort of a celebration. We are a small market, for sure. We're the smallest market in the National Football League by a wide margin, but we're a big community. And I think it's probably very fair to say that no other community on the planet has as close of a nexus to the past, present, and future of the game of football than Green Bay. So now, make no mistake about it, this is a very big deal for our community. This will be the largest event that Green Bay has ever hosted. We expect that over 54 million people will tune in on TV. We project that nearly 250,000 people will visit Green Bay throughout the course of the draft week. This is also going to generate an enormous economic impact, not only in Green Bay, but really throughout the state. This effort's going to be a very heavy lift for us in a small community, but in typical Green Bay style, we won't do it alone. This will be a community effort. So we're going to be working very closely with Discover Green Bay, which is our rebranded CVB. It's headed by Brad Toll and his very dedicated staff. We've also formed a local host committee comprised of community leaders. And together with this group, we've been working on this opportunity for probably almost 7 years, I think. And so we're exceedingly grateful and honored that it's now coming to fruition. And we can't wait to make the 2025 draft in Green Bay the best draft yet. Bring what you got.